I'm Uwe Morgenstern. I'm leading the water dating lab of GNS. In the atmosphere, because of interaction with cosmic ray, there is a little bit of tritium formed, which is in the rain, which is part of the rain. The rainwater is slightly radioactive, and that once the rain goes into the ground, it's separated from the water, separated from the surface, from the atmosphere, and the tritium decays. So by the amount of tritium which is in the groundwater, we can measure how long the water has been underground. So we measure the age of groundwater. We have many projects which involve groundwater dating. One of the most important is Lake Rotorua. So we measure how old the water is when it flows into the lake. So in the water catchment of Lake Rotorua, there is also intensive farming, which introduces nitrate into the ground, and the nitrate travels with the water toward the lake. So the nitrate in the lake causes large problems. So we need to understand how the nitrate travels from the farm to the lake. To measure the age of the water, we need to go into the field. We need to take water samples from the large springs, from all the large streams, all the water which flows into the lake. We collect water samples in 1 liter bottles. We measure conductivity and acidity of the water, and then we take the water into the laboratory. To get a complete picture about the Lake Rotorua catchment water flow, we have gone to all the major sources of water which are sometimes very inaccessible. What we have found in Rotorua is that it takes the water a very long time to reach the lake. So that is from 40 years up to 150 years. That means that also the nitrate from farming practices takes 40 to 150 years to reach the lake. So the nitrate which we are seeing now in Lake Rotorua is that from 50 years ago. There has been a lot of intensification since then, so we expect much more nitrate to flow into the lake. To improve the lake water quality, we need to understand the flow paths and the time lags of the nitrate. The groundwater ages which we measure here are feeding into a groundwater model which can give us very detailed flow paths of the nitrate.
Hi, my name is Mike Taves. I'm a groundwater modeler here at GNS Science. To build a model for groundwater flow in Lake Rotorua, we need to first start with geology. Geologists have mapped the region over several decades, and we can compile this in three dimensions. Here we have Rotorua, Hamarana Springs, Mount Nagataha. Now, water begins, of course, as rain, which falls onto the surface and travels down through each unit and eventually into the lakes and rivers, so that when rain falls and recharges down through the geologic materials, it might travel quick through some layers and slow through others. We've collected water samples throughout the region and looked at their dates. We can correlate these to the ages simulated by the model. As groundwater enters as recharge, it has an age of zero and flows downwards into the deep geologic units and flows back up into the streams and into the lake. For instance, the blue color here is water that is 1 year old, whereas this color represents water that is 20 years old and eventually 80 years old. We would expect the oldest water to be found underneath the lake, as the flow paths have traveled a long distance and are flowing upwards into Lake Rotorua, where it's discharged in the lake bottom. This water is some of the oldest water in the region. We could also simulate the groundwater flow to estimate the life expectancy, that is, how long it will take for any water particle, how long that will take to get to the stream or lake, such that these areas with red might take 100 years or so to reach a stream, whereas areas that are blue might only take a year for the groundwater and nitrates to reach that stream.
The results of our research are summarized in this graph. So here we see nitrate concentration in the groundwater versus groundwater age. So we are going back in time. The groundwater which is older than 100 years is the old pristine groundwater with very low nitrate concentration, when we have a water which is younger than 100 years with slightly elevated nitrate, this is what we correlate to low intensity land use. And the water younger than 50 years has much elevated nitrate concentration. This is this correlates to the time 1960 to the high intensity land use. Most of the groundwater which discharges into the lake now has an age between 50 and 100 years. So these are the groundwaters which are discharging into the lake now. And these low nitrate concentrations, they already cause problems in the lake. But over time, these ones with high nitrate concentration will become the old groundwaters and they will discharge into the lake. And that will cause much more problems. So it is basically a time bomb ticking. The groundwater dating has helped us to understand that there is a big load of nitrate already in the groundwater system, which will flow into the lake no matter what we do now. To improve the lake water quality, we need to limit the nitrate input into the catchment. To set realistic limits, we need to understand how much nitrate is already in the groundwater system.